books are written for us, to us. They are about us, our doctrine.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, I mentioned in Acts 2 where they were told to sell all they had and get rid of it.
Acts 4, same thing. Well, I'll tell you what, that's not Pauline doctrine. You know what Paul says? If you don't take care of your own family, if you don't work, you shouldn't eat. And if you don't take care of your own family, you're worse than what? An infidel. See? So you got some differences there. And the only way to get a hold of these things is that whenever you interpret Scripture, to get it right, you have to interpret it through the prism of what Paul says. And again, Paul's words are the words of whom? I mean, don't, you know, when we talk about Paul, we're talking about, listen, you love your pastor. You love him as a man. You love him as a friend. You love him as a personality.
But the reason why
you pay him respect in terms of the things of God is because he's in a position. He's in the office of bishop. He's the overseer here, and you pay that respect to him because he's in the office. It's the office that gets the respect. He's in it. Paul says, I am the apostle of the Gentiles. I magnify my office. He didn't magnify himself. You know, Paul would say about himself, I'm the chief of sinners. Paul would say about himself, I'm the least of the apostles. Paul would say about himself, I'm the least of the saints. And Paul wasn't speaking piously when he said that. Paul wasn't speaking, some kind of cavalier attitude. No, if Paul said it, then you can bet, because it's exactly how he felt and all that. But if, what do you do when you magnify something? What are you trying to do when you magnify? But you want to be able to what? Want to be able to see. I mean, listen, I know what magnification is. Thank God for magnification.
These are 3.0 now. I started out at 1. I'm